Hello everyone, this is Noah, and today's video we shall be looking at this block machine that was featured in the previous video. Whereas the previous video just showed you some of the parts and how they are assembled together, today's video we shall just be looking at the scale and the dimensions of the machine. Then I'll be giving you a parts overview and trying to explain why the parts are like that. Then next we shall look at the basic motion of the machine and operation. Then finally we shall look at the unique parts of this machine. Well, this block machine is known as a mobile block making machine because this machine makes the blocks on the ground. Now, like for instance, I made a floor here. So you see, so the blocks are formed on the ground. Then afterwards it moves to the next place, you know. So right away you can actually see some of the parts here, and you can see some of the parts of the machine, and from this point here you can see the machine. So this machine here, as I said before, it can actually make various kinds of blocks, and I will be talking about this, explaining this in details. For instance, now we are having a 4-inch hollow blocks mold, but it can actually make 4-inch, 6-inch, and 8-inch blocks. So that's one of the advantages, and it can also be modified to make pavers, as I'll show you later on. And talking about the dimensions and the scale of this machine, we shall get this view here. Then, there is a human model here that we can use for reference. So I usually use this for reference when I'm trying to decide the height of the machine. Now, like for instance, this is the height of this man here. This model here, the dummy, it's about 1.9, that's the height. But you can actually see from here that the machine, the overall length of this machine is about 1.7 meters. Then the overall height, let's say for instance from here at the top to the ground level, you can see here it's about 2 meters, okay, 2.1 meters, and that's the overall what height of the machine to the shed height, to the shed, okay. Then if we change another view, let's say for instance in front here, we can actually get the width of this machine, and see. So the width, this machine is about 800 millimeters wide, but if you take the width from that point, you see it's about 1 meter wide. Okay. Then, so the other thing is that let's say we take the height from this point here and see. So from this point here to the ground, it's about 1.1 meters, okay? So that's some of the overall dimensions of this machine. And when we look at the parts, okay, let's look at the parts. I'll be opening all the parts. So this is our frame here. This is our frame. And as I already said, the frame is where we actually bolt every part. And we see this is the rod that is welded to the frame where the tires are attached. Then this part here, this is where we have our trough. This is our trough. It's attached here, okay? These are the wheels and there. And from here, you see we have this. This is where we have the lifting arm. This is the lifting arm. So this is that joint is here. That's where it pivots, you know. Then another frame, we also have other parts that are joined, and we have these. These are just bushings for these shafts here. See this shaft here? That's where this is just a bushing for the shaft. So you see the shaft slides through that, and we have our mold assembly here. This is the mold assembly, and we have this is our mold for 4-inch hollow blocks. Then this mold here, this is our mold holder, as you see from here. Then we have this is our vertical shaft. This shaft here is just made of maybe steel or something. The vertical shafts have these holders as well, as you see. They have these holders, and those are also bolted to the frame. Okay. Then this is our vibration system. The vibration system just consists of, as usual, we just have a shaft with an eccentric mass. Okay. Then there are two vibration systems on each side, and they are connected using what? This belt. So on one side here we have a single groove belt, on the other side you have a double groove belt, and we also have this. So I put this here just to retain the belt. It just helps us keep the belt on the what? On the pulley. So that one I'll explain more later and I'll show you. But then let me show you that. So the belt retaining part is this. You see here, we want to keep this belt on this pulley, so that's why we have this. So at some point the belt may try to get off the pulley, but this will stop it from what? I'm going off the pulley. That's why we have that there. And let's go back to our mold. And yeah, I've talked about the spring. So now let's talk about these other molds here. Okay. Yeah, I've said this is the 4-inch block mold. But then we also have a 6-inch. And so this is a 6-inch block mold. It makes 3 of them. And from here you can see that we just need to unbolt the vibration unit and just bolt it there. Then just try to put the 8-inch block. So this is the 8-inch block mold, and it also fits. We just have to unbolt and put the bolt. We just have to bolt the vibration unit in place. See, it fits well. Then let's try to see what about the roofing slab blocks, you know. So these are the blocks they use for roofing slabs, and that's how it fits, you know. So then we have to unbolt this and bolt the vibration bolt system on it. Then we also have the paving unit here. This is our paving unit. For the paving unit, we just need one vibration system on this side, because on the other side it can't fit, as you see. So we just have to put a vibration system on one side here. Okay, so let's just go back to our 4-inch block. Yeah, this is our 4-inch block. Let's just go back to this one. So okay, I'll close this and we'll go to our next part. So before I close, I just want us to look around the machine and see how it looks like. You know? So yeah, this is our design this machine. Okay, now let's go to the next part. That's the material trough. This is our material trough, and this is where the concrete mix is poured. And then after it's pushed into the mold, okay? That's how it looks like. And these are the holes for the bolts. These are the holes for the bolts. Next, let's look at the wheels. These are the wheels we're having here. As you see, they are just basic wheels with this shaft here. This is just a thick bush that is welded to a round plate, and then you have some webs here just for extra support, and that's our wheel. Then this is just a rubber thing around the wheel, just a rubber. Maybe glued or something to the wheel. Okay. Then next we have the lifting arm. This is our lifting arm. From here you can see it has. So some of these things here, they will come in as issues to determine how long this machine will work. Now, for instance, you see here we have this hole, which actually just connects to this. You see. So these parts here really need to be lubricated, these joints here, just to allow them to prevent any kind of friction that will lead to maybe wear, and maybe the machine leading to wear, okay? So we have to lubricate these parts to reduce friction that may reduce the life of the machine. So these parts need to be lubricated, these joints here, okay? Then that was the lifting arm connector. This is the lifting arm connector. So I just call it the lifting arm connector because it connects the lifting arm to the mold. And this is it here, okay? This is the lifting arm, and this is the mold holder. So this is the thing that links the two, okay? Then the motor, this is our motor here, the electric motor. The electric motor is used to drive the vibration systems in the molds. Then we have the motor mounting plate, so that's just where the motor is what? Bolted, you see? So the motor is bolted on this mounting plate. And then we have the compaction unit. This is our compaction unit, okay? Assembly. Compaction unit. Let's open that and talk more about it. So this is our compaction unit, as you see from here. And the basic motion of this machine here is, you see that? It just slides. It slides along the rail, okay? And that's the basic motion, that's what it does, okay? So you see, on the compaction unit, on this compaction unit, we have various parts. And some of these are, we have, this is our press. And from here, from this point of view, you see the shape of this press? This is the same shape of the what? Of the hollow block. And we are making how many? Making four. Four inch hollow blocks. So four inch hollow blocks. The ones I shall be making. So the press is actually bolted. You see? It's bolted to that, okay? And that's one of the advantages of this machine, is that most of these parts are swappable. You can swap one part for another in case you're making some different product, making another type of block. You just have to swap and put them on the press that is required, okay? And then we have these are our bushings here, and these are our bushings as well. So these bushings are the ones that allow the vertical motion of the compaction unit. Okay, so let's close that. So you see the ones here. It seems slow, but I just wanted to show you that they allow that kind of motion to occur. Those are just bushings, eh? So those bushings are actually bolted to this compaction unit track. So I call it the compaction unit track, as I said, because the compaction unit moves, it slides on the track. Yeah. Then what else we have here is this. This is for adjusting the block height. So this is a block height adjusting bolt. Okay, when you untie this bolt, and you can actually adjust the height of the block. And I think that's all. Then we also have these two bolts here. These bolts here, as you see here, they are used for aligning the compaction unit with the mold. So you see, in case our mold is here, you see, and this is here. So this, when it comes here, we can adjust these bolts so that we have this press aligned with the compaction unit. So we just have to adjust these bolts here. That's why we have these bolts. And this is just the arm for pulling and pushing the press or the compaction unit to and fro, you see. So that's what we use. And I think these are the parts of this machine. And this is our vibration. This is the top vibration motor, okay? The vibration motor for the upper part. So then next, let's talk about the locking system for the compaction unit. So this compaction unit has a locking system, actually. From this point of view, you can see it. It's a locking system because let me try to hide some of these things so that we can actually see what I'm trying to explain here. You see, at this point here, as I said before, our compaction unit can move up and can also move down. It can slide up and down, okay? So when it slides up, you know, now let's say for instance, the compaction unit is at this point, okay? When it slides up, this compaction unit lock will be pushed out of the way, okay? It will be pushed out of the way. And when this crosses, this will fall back, okay? It will fall back and grab the compaction unit, okay? And hence, locking gets in place, okay? Yeah. It will have locked it in place. So, and the other thing I explained is the height, block height adjusting bolt. So this is the block height adjusting bolt. Now say for instance, you have unlocked the compaction unit. When you unlock it like this, by pushing this backwards, it will fall to move down. And as you see, it is moving down, okay? You see, also the bolt is moving. So at some point, this bolt will come in contact with the frame. And when it does so, this means we shall have attained our what? Our block, required block height, okay? Now let's say, And the other thing I talked about is the aligning the what? The press with the mold. You see, this is our mold here. But now look at where the press is, okay? So what we need to do here is that we need to pull this. See? when you pull it forward, at some point, it will come in contact with this plate here. And when it comes in contact with this plate, you adjust these bolts until the press is aligned with the mold. Okay? Until it is aligned with the mold. So that's why we have these bolts here. These two bolts. Just to align the press with the mold. So, and I think I've explained the 2 points. Aligning the press with the mold and also adjusting the block height from here. Then, next we shall look at this is a lock. Then we have the motor pulley. The pulley, we shall talk about that. The belt retainer. I talked about the belt retainer for the mold. But then at the motor point here, we also have another belt retaining plate or part. So you see here, we have this part here, or the plate here, that is actually bolted to the mounting, to this motor mount plate. Okay, so what it does is that we have this bolt, so it prevents this bolt from going out of the pulley, so it keeps the bolt at some level. So to prevent, we can actually add some lubricant on this plate here, just to allow it to slide and reduce friction. So we can put something like graphite or something that is just a dry lubricant, yeah, to make it smooth. So that's why we have this retainer here, to keep the bolt on the motor pulley. So that's one of the conditions that occurs with the machines, whereby the bolt, at some point the bolt will actually move off the pulley. So that's the part I put there for that. Then we have the roof, actually. Where is it? We have the roof. The machine has a shed. Okay. The machine has a shed, so for instance, in case someone is working in a sunny day, we have this shed here that can provide some protection to the worker or to the operator. Okay, so I put the shed as well. Then I think I've talked about, I've mixed the two parts, and so at this point, we shall just be looking at the operation of the machine now. I've mixed two parts we had to talk about, so I talked to them about them at once. But let's talk about, before talking about the operation of the machine, let's look at the basic motion of this machine. So, first of all, we have the lifting arm. This is our lifting arm. And you see it moves. It moves like this. So you have to grab onto these grips, then you push them down. It moves up and down. Up and down. That's the motion of the arm. Then we also have, we have the compaction. It has this kind of motion. Up, down, and up. It slides along this shaft, okay? It slides on this shaft up and down. Then it also has another motion. When you push this arm here backwards, it slides backwards, okay? That's another motion. And then there is another motion here, which is the locking system. The locking system automatically locks the compaction unit in place, and the basic motion it does is moving up like this, in and goes out like that. So So this, I think these are the basic motion of the machine. And the other motion is that it actually moves on the ground using the wheels. That's another kind of motion. So since I've explained the motion, I'll be talking about the operation now. But first of all, I forgot to introduce the spreading tool. This is our spreading tool. The spreading tool is, so if someone has concrete, they bring the concrete and then they pour it on what? On the trough. When they pour it on the trough here, you can use this spreading tool to push the concrete into the mold, okay? So the spreading tool just has basically rubber here and this plate, this long pour. So the operator uses it to push the concrete into the mold, okay? So now let's talk about the operation. So first and foremost, our machine is in this state. Let's lock the compaction unit. So at this point, the compaction unit is locked upwards and it is pushed backwards, you know. So it's pushed on the other side. At this point, we have enough room to fill the mold with material. So what we do is that some operator or worker will bring the concrete mix and then they pour it on what? On the trough here. When they pour it on the trough, they use a spreading tool and then push it into the mold, okay? They push it into the mold and then fill up the mold, okay? Then after filling up the mold, we can actually switch on this motor here to provide the vibration to the mold, okay? So after turning on the mold vibration, the material will settle, will keep on settling. Then afterwards, at some point, it will stop settling and it will actually just keep on level. So at this point, we shall then pull the compaction unit in place. So we pull this compaction unit to come in line with the what? With the mold. Then afterwards, we shall then open this, unlock the compaction unit. When you unlock it, it will then fall down. And then at this point, it will start compressing the what? The material in the mold. And at this point, you can also switch on this vibration here. Just it provides more compaction to the material as it is compacting the material in the mold. So when this bolt comes in contact with the frame, it indicates that the required block height has been reached. So after that point, we just switch off everything. Then the operator will lift the arm and then we have our blocks here, okay? Then move the concrete block, move the what? The concrete block machine behind. So we shall have our concrete blocks that have been made on the ground, okay? So those are our concrete blocks. So then this cycle repeats again, and as we make more blocks, okay? So I don't know, but I tried to make an animation video of this, and I realized that my computer can't actually make an animation video because of this assembly. It has a lot of parts in it. So maybe when I get a better computer, I'll upload videos of how this machine operates. And most of the machines I've uploaded, I haven't uploaded as just a motion video showing how they work because of the many parts that are involved. Many parts, they slow down the computer. So So actually, I think that was the explanation of how the machine works. The special parts, I don't know. I think I've already introduced all the special parts on this machine. And I've talked about all the parts. And I also talked about the shed. There is nothing else that is left, okay? And with that said, I think that is it for this machine and this video. I hope to see you guys in the next one. And thank you for watching up to this point. Take care.